Ladies and gentlemen, good to have you all here and welcome to the DMEXCO 2018 in Cologne. This is the meeting place for key players in digital business and marketing and innovation. And welcome to our Motion Stage, which is the platform for the future of video for influencer marketing, digital storytelling or brand and content. The very last session 2018 is represented by a company that has been founded 7 years ago in Los Angeles. Since the beginning of its advertising business, Snapchat has always been the home of progressive marketers, from 100-year-old businesses to turbocharged startups. Will Scougal, International Director of Creative Strategy, talks now to leading advertisers Adidas, LeVou, and creative agency Jung von Matt about embracing the first new creative canvas in the decade and how it is getting them serious brand and business results. Welcome to stage, gentlemen.
Hi, everybody.
Do you guys feel like you're on a game show, just a little bit? Okay, fingers on the
buzzer. So impressive. I love it.
It's a great stage. I mean, no one fell over going up the stairs either. So guys, absolutely delighted to be here today to talk to you about camera marketing and the role it plays in camera native conversation. Thrilled to be joined by Eric, Christian and Max, who will introduce themselves in just a moment. But before they do, I just thought I'd set some context around what we mean by camera marketing, what we mean by camera natives, and a little bit around what we're going to be talking about. So at Snapchat, we're seeing a massive behavioral shift to people using the camera, not just to capture picture-perfect moments, but to use it as a tool for creativity, for self-expression, for discovery, actually using it as a communications tool, talking with pictures, and actually using it as the best and fastest way to communicate with their friends. And we're seeing it at such a huge volume that actually, just kind of to set some context, if we look at 2017, there are actually more snaps, more content created through the native Snapchat camera than there were through all iOS camera devices globally. And that's kind of a mind-boggling statistic to a certain degree. And camera natives for us are people that are very comfortable with this behavior. They're very comfortable with the idea of using their camera, not just as a tool for kind of capturing a moment, but for using it as a way to communicate. And camera marketing offers brands an authentic and relevant path into that high intent, high attention moment when people are looking at the camera and using it in that way. So I'm gonna pass over to the guys just to introduce themselves so they can tell you a little bit about where they're from and who they are. Then we're gonna play a short sizzle showing a few examples of great camera marketing. And then we're gonna dig into it and get into some of the facts behind what makes camera marketing work and hopefully kind of dispel some of the myths behind Snapchat and camera marketing as well. So over to you guys for a quick introduction.
You want to start?
Sure. Yeah, Eric Jangor, my name. I'm from LeVou. LeVou is a German dating app, or the German dating app. I think still the biggest one in the market, even if Tinder is perceived as being bigger. I'm heading communications at LeVou as VP marketing, so internal and external communication, and also the brand and the brand communication. That's my job.
Thanks, Eric. Great to have you here.
Yeah, I'm Christian Rost from Adidas. I'm working in the brand communication department, actually for Adidas football in Germany. And within this team, I take responsibility mainly for the local social media channels. And when it comes to media plannings, I'm the guy who has a look on the special media parts and social. Yeah.
Thanks, Christian.
Great. I'm Max Lederer. I work at Jung von Matt. We are a creative agency, 2 times Independent Agency of the Year this year in Cannes and in New York festivals. I'm the creative lead for brands like BMW, Montblanc, Huawei. Got a digital background and excited to be here. Thanks.
Great. Thanks very much. I think it's worth pointing out that the guys and the businesses that they represent have been long-standing partners of ours and have been doing some of the most innovative work with us and have really lent into the idea of camera marketing and what can be achieved with it. Just to give you a kind of a quick example of some of the work, I'm going to play a short sizzle now, and then we'll discuss it in a bit more detail as we go through the panel. Stuff. So I think we'll kick off with a question to all of you to get things started. And in true game show style, whoever answers first gets to speak first. in terms of the relationship we've had over the last couple of years and the work that you've been doing, what first drew you to Snapchat as an advertising platform? How have you found the journey with us over the last 2 years as we've both kind of developed together as advertisers and as a advertising platform?
Yeah,
really? You?
We as Adidas, we have the kind of creativity in our DNA, and the World Cup claim creativity is the answer, and our ambition to be the creators brand. We are always searching for possibilities, platforms to communicate to our audience in a very creative way. And additionally, we set the consumer in the focus of what we are doing. And both things, from our point of view, we felt there's a great match to the philosophy and the tools Snapchat is offering. So actually, this combination bring us, especially locally, but also years ago globally, towards you.
Fantastic. Thanks very much. And Lovu, what about you in terms of the way you've been using video formats?
So we started with Snapchat like 1.5 years ago, roughly. Yep. So when you open up for advertising, basically. Our goal is always to be first in. So we want to be a first mover in all marketing efforts that we put in. We are a pure performance marketer. So we're not doing that much brand advertising yet.
Yep.
And that's why it's important for us to find channels where we have traffic and where users are. And from a brand standpoint, it's also that was one positive thing. It's also important for us to be on Snapchat because Snapchat as a brand is what I perceive as a good and young, mobile-first, social-affine brand. And this is also how we want to be perceived. And that's why being on Snapchat as a platform is a branding in itself, even if we only do performance ads.
Yeah, it's interesting you mentioned brand and performance together there, because I do think that certainly in terms of the premium nature of some of the formats on Snapchat, or all of the formats really, there's a higher creative craft request on some advertisers, whether they're doing performance or brand, and that's kind of bringing both of those worlds a little bit closer together. I think I'll turn to you, Max, and just ask from a Yonva Matt's perspective, have you noticed a shift and a change in what brands are asking for from you as a creative agency, and how have they started to brief you or change the way they speak to you when asking for creative and content?
Well, I think Snapchat grew out of its early days where it's just been a lot of curiosity about it, and we're still fighting a lot of to enable people to gather enough knowledge about the channel and the actual functions. We're still struggling to enable customers to understand what a filter, what a lens is. So I really reach out for you guys and wish for more knowledge-based communication. And in the last 3 or 4 years, you guys have been just doing an outstanding job enabling us, helping us, communicating to brands and showing them the actual potential of the channel. And now we reach this kind of serious peak where it's not seen as this app for younger audiences, but those audiences grew out of this age. Plus, we see creativity just exploding in various formats, the same we saw here as Adidas is using it, and more cases are evolving and showing brands that this is actually a channel where you, yes, can build on creativity, and the channel itself is built on creativity, because actually every chat, if it's not just a video, invites you to play around and create something. So definitely for us, this is just a great creative playground, and we are struggling mostly with bias and prejudices regarding it's just young audiences. We can really reach out to brands if we show them how much interaction is happening there. We get interaction rates 4 to 5 minutes with some of our products and lenses, which is, I think, astonishing when you're looking at the attention span and other channels. So it's just a great playground. And evolving, and I think our most important job is to communicate it, to explain it over and over, because it is a very closed system. We're also struggling with classical corporations who need to show their boss what they actually did on a channel, and when we tell them, okay, there's been 500 snaps or 50 snaps, and where can I see them? Yeah, well, they're gone, you know? So, okay, we prepared them for you, but it's really tough for them to really dig into that idea of a chat. And I think the last thing that's really important and makes it so fascinating is that it's so intimate, right? Because you're not on a timeline, and we just try to, make brands figure out timelines, how they work, but now we're in a chat. We're very in an intimate conversation, and I think we have to be really careful how brands jump in there, so not to scare the customers away, because it is the most intimate conversation that's going on there, in my opinion.
I mean, I agree with you, and I think that often as a creative team internally, we talk about brands understanding the creation and consumption mindset of people on Snapchat. You know, when you're a performance advertiser and you're looking to deliver a very succinct, very precise message to drive a very particular action, you're thinking about the pacing that you deliver that message is similar to how, you and I might snap. If we're talking with pitchers, I might ask you if you want to go for a drink after this panel, and it would be literally a 2-3 second interaction where you'd consume it, understand it, and respond in kind. And then at the same time, we've got much deeper experiences happening where people are adding filters to snaps and considering them for a number of seconds, or spending a really long time immersed in an augmented reality experience where they're really, spending 20, 30, 40 seconds kind of playing with that moment. We've got a great example up we're going to show just now. So Moments obviously offer an incredible opportunity, not just from a camera marketing perspective, but just marketing in general. We're all familiar with the idea of having a moment strategy and using that to kind of leverage some equity for the brand. I think Adidas did this brilliantly on Snapchat during the World Cup. And we're just going to show a quick example of what they did. And then hopefully Christian will be able to talk us through it a little bit and shed some light on the process and the idea and the creative.
Yeah, great. Thanks a lot. As you can see there are three parts mainly, and this stands for a kind of holistic approach we together with Snapchat created. Our aim was that we find a way to engage our audience, our target group audience, the core creator, the core football creator is around 17 years old. His life is not a mess, but he has a lot to do the whole day. So many snaps, so many WhatsApps, whatever, everything is going on. And we wanted to create kind of funnel where we were able to engage with him through the World Cup. And as a local market, Germany, we focused on the main match days we could foresee. These were the DFB matches in the group stage.
Yeah.
We started with building up a huge concept where the base were the Snap ads. These are not visible here, but I guess everybody in the room knows the Snap ads. We were able to bring our campaign message, our campaign clip, into the video ads in a short format. We could link to the longer form to take care that the audience on Snapchat gets the clip. The campaign message was creativity is the answer. But as you might can imagine, landing the message creativity is the answer needs a little bit more than just the clip and watch it, no matter how big and how great it is. So we started to think, what else can we do? And there's the first example. We created filters, national filters, but for us it was not enough to only have one filter for each DFB group stage match game and one other game. We wanted to create filters that are dynamic, filters that evolve during a day. So when we started, this was actually the first match day. It was linked to another ad format I will mention later. And you see there is a locker room. It was the first DFB match day. You see your Snapchat name on the DFB jersey. You see our latest boot in the locker room. And you see the campaign claim, and there's a countdown running. And when the game started, countdown is zero, we changed the filter. And it appears a filter possibility that the Snap user were able to fill in the result she or he guessed. And when the game ends, we actually inserted the correct result, and so we were able to offer every user the perfect piece to share and to spread. It was meant to be a positive result, but you know it all how it worked. This was one fact. No, this was one thing. Later.
Soll ich play this one?
Yes,
hey exactly. Leute, wollt ihr bei der Weltmeisterschaft vor unserem ersten Spiel ganz nah bei uns in der Kabine sein? Dann jetzt einfach hochswipen. Viel Spaß.
Cool.
Das war der Thomas, der uns geholfen hat, unser Highlight beim ganzen ersten Aufschlag auf Snapchat zu bewerben. Und zwar hat er dafür geworben, einfach virtuell live im Lockerroom zu sein. Also direkt am Tag des ersten Spiels des World Cups vom DFB.
Can you speak in English?
Oh, sorry.
his mic was broken.
Actually, I switched from right? Thomas Müller, because he was speaking in German. But as you see, this is actually the best example, because me, I totally get what he said, and he got me.
Yeah.
And this was the clue of the ad. He took so many people into our portal lands that crashed all the benchmarks Snapchat had. And now we maybe can have a look on where all the users went.
I mean, it's a wonderful kind of endemic style. You feel like you're getting a snap from Thomas Müller, and he's inviting you to swipe up. And then when you swipe up on the ad, you launch this AR experience, which I will let Christian talk you through.
Yeah, as you can see, the main camera is opening, and then you had just two steps forward going into the locker room. And in the locker room, you had an engaging fact. You can tap, and there's Mesut Özil and Thomas Müller playing around with the ball, featuring the new jersey, featuring the brand new boots. You can walk around in the room, and what's there? Oh, there's a username on the DFB logo. Great. Oh, what's happening there? Is this a new X? Great one. And creativity is the answer. Okay.
And then the button there at the bottom could take you through to...
Yeah, exactly. So in the end, we were able to really get the most important thing of our football creator, and that's time. None of the teenagers, the co-creators, has time, and we had more than 27 seconds of focused target audience in our lens. Even more, 37 seconds when they entered via Snapcode. So we also got a link from the real world to the digital world, just scanning a Snapcode. It was even better. And so in the end, we really reached our goals with this creative solutions all together.
I mean, I think when we think about advertising, often, you know, as marketers, we're really trying to get two things from the people we want to talk to. We're trying to get them to spend on our product, but also to give us their attention. We want them to give us their attention so we can talk to them about what it is that we can offer. And I think that, you know, lenses offer a fantastic path through to that, as do filters. But I think with Lavu in particular, what you guys have identified is that there's an always-on attention through the camera. Whenever you open up Snapchat, you are opening up the camera. It gives you a view of the world around you, the tool with which to augment it, to enhance it. You're automatically focused in on what's happening through it. And if you swipe to the right-hand side, what you get is a premium video content experience with our Discover partners, and a logo of really kind of maximized the attention that people are giving to that space. We're going to have a quick look at some of their ads here, and hopefully you'll be able to talk us through some of the creative.
Yeah, maybe I can introduce it a bit before we
play, of course.
Because it's hard to speak after such an amazing case. It's incredible. I wish we could do something too in the future. Maybe you can join a date via VR and learn something. Let's see. It's a good inspiration.
It's a Snapchat date.
So basically, so obviously your goal was have a maximum spend of time with your brand. So that is not our goal. Our goal is to get users really quick and to guide them to the App Store or to the Play Store and guide them to an install. That is basically what we are trying to do, and we play around a lot with Snapchat because that is obviously also an audience that is very thankful and rewards you for playing around and for being creative and for trying to, for example, use content that people are used to, like selfie videos, authentic content, and the first example.
Should I play this one?
Ja, you can
du wirst endlich mal Leute auf deiner Wellenlänge kennenlernen. Hol dir jetzt die LaVou-App und schau, wer sich in deiner Nähe befindet. Chatte mit ihnen und vielleicht versteht man sich ja besser, als man denkt.
And this guy, so it's an amateur actor from Berlin, and you might not was expecting somebody like this for on an ad for a dating app, right? So that was our strategy by the end of last year. We wanted to break the polished world of dating apps by always promising big love, perfect match, all that stuff that we also have been doing so far. And we wanted to be more real in a way. That was our claim. Jetzt erst echt would be real right now. I wouldn't switch to German now. And so this is our best performing ad, by the way. And this proves that also this maybe unnormal, special-looking guy is a hook for people, so they actually swipe up, they install, and that shows that we might be on the right way with this, and we have different other formats. Also, this one is a different one.
And I think it's a great example. Both all of them are of thinking about that creation and consumption mindset that people are in when they're on the platform, like in the style, in the way it's shot, in the delivery of the message, in the kind of the clear copy and the clear drive to action. But let's play this middle one here as well.
It's actually, the topic is what are you gonna do to get a date? It's an older creative, one of our first creatives on Snapchat. You can realize that at the old logo, so the logo is now tilted to the side and not not symmetrical anymore. Also a good one. We have that also with the new logo because it was working pretty well. What I wanted to show here is that humor, irony, meme speech, that is obviously what millennials are up to. And the last one I can talk about.
Swipe hoch zum Installieren.
What I wanted to show here is you could hear the weird voiceover. We did that via iPhone. On our own, we do all the ads in-house, so we have a creative team in-house, so that's important to mention. And what I wanted to show here is that if you try to do ads on Snapchat, on mobile ads you're used to ignoring the sound, because most of the people, they have a sound off. At Snapchat it's quite a difference, and also a short voiceover like this could make a huge difference. We A/B tested it with voiceover and without voiceover, and we found out that with the voiceover it's working way better. And that is what I wanted to show here. And next up will be ads that deliver a stance. You could see that with Nike last week. I was in New York City, and the Times Square was lit up with this big Kaepernick ad that Nike was created.
Yeah.
And they saw a boost in sales of 30%, talking about performance. And I think delivering a stance, showing an attitude, is totally also totally millennial, totally Snapchat.
Yeah.
And that's what we're going to do next.
Is it, I mean, it's another great example of how creative craft can drive results.
Exactly.
And performance, which I think is sometimes something we don't necessarily associate mobile with. But even up here, what you've got is something that's kind of quite endemic to Snapchat. You've got something that's kind of tapped into meme culture, and then something that's kind of just kind of demonstrative of what the app actually does. So it's kind of three very different kind of creative routes. I think kind of taking it back to sort of more of a brand marketing objective, I'd like to just
Can I ask you a question with that first one? Did you choose the guy for his looks only or also for his dialect?
Both.
Because for me, it felt like, I don't know whether you people understood, but this was like a southern German dialect, and it felt very close to me, much closer than a, you know, high German poster boy model. So this I think, bought into the idea of we're very close to you, wherever we are. That's Le Vu. Is that?
I love that you're seeing it, actually. No, I mean,
thank you. No, that's just,
that,
I was
that
just
was
wondering.
Totally, because that was totally the purpose. Okay. Because you, I'm from Saxony, nothing to be super proud of those times. The dialect also, the Saxony dialect is a special one, as well as the Schwäbisch and Bavarian. And I don't know what Schwäbisch is in English. But
I don't either.
It's exactly, you can connect to, even if
Cockney
you're not...
guy. Yeah.
even if you're not from Stuttgart, you can connect to a dialect that is outstanding or something like that. I love that you realize that.
That's what I mean with this intimate appearance, right? That's like how you should appear in Snapchat, and that's a tough one for some brands. Because if you put in that typical model, you know, you're cleaned up makeup guy, and then you just don't gain that close attention of people.
It was the same reason why we've chosen Thomas Müller for this ad. Because you're not, you can't choose any player. Mm. He's the one he's catchy. He's the one who can act in front of the camera.
Yeah.
So everyone likes him, right? Everyone loves him.
Yeah, a lot of people love.
And his mouth looks like a lens, right?
Yeah.
Moving on. So Jon van Matt, you worked with BMW to create what we kind of refer to as the first product trial lens, and I think there was a really interesting business challenge there from BMW that was set, which was along the lines of, for the launch of the new X5, X2. Apologies.
No problem.
Apologies. For the new launch of the new X2, part of the challenge was actually getting people into the showroom to try the car, to experience it, to look around it. And actually, when you get people to do that, there's a higher proclivity to actually going and booking a test drive. And so there was this concept that developed around kind of turning the world into a showroom, and you guys were kind of instrumental in creating this piece of AR that was incredibly innovative for us at the time, and certainly led the way to lots of other lenses of a similar style. But maybe you could, I'll play this, and maybe you could talk us through what happened here.
Well, what you see here...
No, I'm just talking to you. Maybe let's just play it and then I'll talk about it. It's pretty self-explanatory, I think.
Great explanation, Max.
No, I'll get to it. I just want to enjoy the beautiful work. So BMW addressed us for the campaign of their new X2, which is the youngest, most progressive car in the portfolio. It's actually launched in that really golden color. It got the biggest rim size that you can get in this kind of segment. Got huge exhaust pipes, so it's such a car. It's just a car for people who want to be, you know, extroverted, show off. And the whole campaign was focusing on an urban digital target group around the world. And also in that time, and you know that's some kind of problem I'll be struggling with, of course, they said they want to try out something on Snapchat, and we then, together with you guys, tackled them, and I think this was one of the big wins that we both approached the customer and tried in many creative rounds and iterations to find the best solution for them. And yes, the actual result at the end, the configuration process is always the benchmark in the car manufacturing or car advertising, but there was much more before that. So our first question was, how will we get people in Snapchat in that closed room? And then, do we get the right ones? And how do we get their attention? So we actually hit little snap ghosts in our moving images, and the whole campaign was produced, pre-produced for many different channels. And BMW, from the last 2 or 3 years, went away from this reproducing one piece of moving images, but rather producing multi-purpose moving imagery for all the channels. And then we hit little snap goals inside and just waited, and like on Facebook and YouTube, and waited if the audience would actually pick on that. And obviously, of course, they found out, and you could snap that. So we had one entrance in there. And then we first introduced a face lens because it felt the most natural way to communicate, or the first natural way for a lens in Snapchat is actually a face lens. So we used that, just that golden color, and targeted some people, and it was amazing. It was over 7 million impressions on that lens and 7 million snaps with that lens. And then we retargeted that audience and put a next media flight on top of that and provided that world lens, so to say, because you obviously have to switch your camera. And here you can actually position the car wherever you want.
So that was the second one. You teased it with the golden.
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. And when you when you have that lens and you switch the camera, you got a face lens. Mm-hmm. And again, there's so many things. We have to be really open-minded in that channel, open-minded to the audience, because when I first saw the face lens, I thought, okay, who would want to do that? But 7 million people did. So it's. I think we all have to constantly learn what Gen Z millennials would like to do and want to participate in your brand. So then here you could position the car, turn it around, and you could color it in the three main launch colors, and that was like more than we could ever wish for, because again, this is a lens in a native app. This is not a downloaded application. Of course, you have to download the lens, but it's actually a model, but there you usually would be like millions of polygons, and you guys helped us in that lens studio to really narrow it down, plus the customer was still happy with the appearance. Yep. And the actual world lens was shared over, I think, 17 million times, and the usual interaction rate was about 4 minutes. Mm. So someone is playing around 4 minutes with a product that you cannot buy already in the market. Younger audiences playing around with it in this intimate environment for us was just a really, really great case to learn. Really, because it is a first moving thing, we constantly learn, and to learn together with our customers how to approach those audiences.
Well, I'm just going to play it again because I think I distracted people by kind of interrupting the video there.
But, okay. Yeah.
And it is a really beautiful piece of work, I think.
Ba-dum.
Ba-dum.
Yeah, what I said, switch the color. And the cool thing is, of course, the audience was playing around with it. Usually we tell the customer, hey, they will put that car in front of their, you know, house and position it there. But people just got crazy. They put it on their head, they put it on their tongue, put it on the desk, you know, playing around with it. But that's a tough one. That's a tough one for corporations like BMW, because now they really have to let go a little of their, you know, desire to control every image that's out there with their car. And it was really, thanks to their bravery and their trust in us, that they make it happen, made it happen.
So thanks very much. I mean, I think that there are so many things going on in all of those campaigns. When we think about kind of the targeting that's available on Snapchat, the ability to be able to deliver the snap ads that would swipe up to the lens to the right audience and then gather those people together in a group and then being able to retarget them further on through the campaign to help kind of drive them through the funnel. I think that certainly when we started with AR 2.5 years ago with the famous rainbow lens, a lot of what we can do now wasn't even really kind of being thought of, but we do think about certainly AR on Snapchat as a full funnel, very highly targetable format that can be delivered on a national level or kind of through reach and frequency to an audience over any given period of time. And it's interesting that I think all of those examples really tap into this the idea of brands embracing the creation and consumption mindset of people on the platform. BMW, you know, being a very premium brand, kind of giving up the color of the car, the new gold X2, and allowing people to kind of turn their face that color is something that's a bit of a leap for a brand marketer, but something that was embraced. And I think we all saw great results off the back of it. I think that something else that's kind of worth mentioning within this group and bringing up is the launch of the Lens Studio. So the Lens Studio is the proprietary piece of Snapchat software that we use to create all augmented reality on the platform, and it's something that we've opened up to members of the public. So anyone can go and download the same tool that we use, the software that we use to create AR on Snapchat and start to create their own AR experiences. It's something that, like I say, anyone can start to build the platform. But I wondered if I could just ask if you guys had started to think about, I mean, you mentioned how you have internal creative. Obviously, Jan van Maat's built around around the idea of creativity. If you started to play around with the Lens Studio yourselves, or started to speak to some of the AR creators that are building, you know, incredible pieces of AR content for the platform.
So we've never tried it yet. So that's an easy one.
Is it something that, I mean, as a business that does have a kind of a high, places a high value on creativity and high turnover creativity, so testing multivariant formats against different audiences, do you think that there is a role for AR to play when you think about performance and how, and bringing some of the learnings that you've got from, say, SnapAd performance into AR?
I mean, if you look at Snapchat as an advertising environment. I don't know if everybody's familiar with all the advertising formats at Snapchat, but it's Moments, it's Lens, it's Snap Ads, and it's the Story Ads, right?
Yes, yeah. And filters.
Welcome. So, we first started with the Snap Ads, so the ads that you could see between snaps, obviously, because that was the highest performing ad, and we now also did Story Ads. Story Ads, most of the advertisers use this as a brand channel.
Yeah,
we've also have proven that this is working for performance reasons. So it's a story that you see as a little kachel, like when you scroll through the discover feed. And there's one step further to the performance channel. So you have to open the story ad and then swipe up instead of only swiping up. So one more action.
Yeah.
And I could totally imagine that that we could combine this with AR, VR in the future, with filters as well, because you could also see you were calling to an action that people had to take, downloading a lens. Thomas Müller was calling for swiping up, and maybe we could get also somebody like Thomas Müller, or in our case, maybe Matthias Schweighöfer or somebody like that, to swipe up for a date with him. So that is great. That maybe in a Lens, why not?
Is the Lens Studio something that you've been playing around with at Jan van Maat in the creative studio?
Well, yeah, we actually have, like, you know, introduced people or trying always to find biotopes and environments for people who got that knowledge, working with like Unity, WebGL, 3D, CGI, and provide them the tools. And yes, the Lens Studio is a good tool. The challenge I see, like, for this whole session here around those halls is we're not lacking technology, we're lacking talent and creative talent to play around with technology. And if I look at Snapchat, I have to combine first people that are used to see the world through a camera interface that goes for all the modern social media channels that work with camera interfaces. And we found that it is really much harder for us in classical production companies to come or to get that view through that camera. So I'm not directly talking influencers. I mean that we try to really get people to work for us that are already living it. And most of the young people are looking through that camera lens. And right now we're a lot working with experts in that field, trying to get them from their desks and saying, hey, you're a heavy sharer on Snapchat, you're a heavy sharer on another platform. So please, can you help us develop that content for the customer? Because again, the customer has to let go of his typical clean advertising environment. And then bring that together. If you talk in AR, you have to have that view through a camera perspective. People who grew up talking through their friends through camera lenses. And then you have to combine it with people who have the knowledge to use that technology like AR and make a story out of it. And that is right now, I think, our biggest struggle. We all struggle that we all got these great innovations, but we're so technology driven that it stays cold on the outside. And I would say for us at Jung von Matt, the biggest challenge now is to do what we can do best, tell emotional stories through technology. So you have to have at least three different parties to come up with a good AR case. And again, this is still rough. I think what we're experiencing now, looking at, like, you know, data size, polygon levels, we all start just starting with AR, but I think we all agree that what we're going to be looking at in the future will just be amazing. You know, diving into that locker room in 5 years from now, it's already amazing, but it's just opening worlds we cannot imagine right now. But what lacks is talent and creativity for storytelling in those channels.
Yeah, I mean, the hardware and software, the changes that have happened even over the last couple of years have just been, you know, made huge changes in just the way that brands can bring their story to life, the way that they can kind of appear in that kind of creation consumption mindset. And I think that one of the things that really kind of benefits the way you guys have worked is you've understood that advertising on Snapchat from a from a user point of view, from a Snapchatter point of view, is built around the idea of choice. Right? I will choose to scan my face and launch augmented reality. I want to go and play with AR at that time. And the opportunity for brands then is to actually contribute to that experience, actually understand that's where I want to be and not try to, I guess, kind of disrupt the moment, but actually make it as amazing and as good as it can be. And it's the same from the content side of the app. People go to that side of the app to be informed, to be entertained, and the brands that go there with an interesting creative arc, that go there to make that experience great, are the ones that I think win through in the end. So I'm conscious of time. I think we've only got a few minutes left. So I wanted to finish with just a couple of questions that are hopefully kind of, again, kind of useful and interesting to the audience. If as brands and agencies that have worked with us for a while, that have been with us on a bit of a journey, what piece of advice would you give to advertisers that are possibly just thinking about starting out on Snapchat or starting to think about camera marketing? What piece of advice would you give them in starting to work with us?
I would say listen to your customers. Listen to your customers and know how they behave on the platform, how they interact and trust in creative experts. We, from during our project, trusted in the Snapchat creative team. We also have great agencies sitting next to us. Trust in these creative guys who have knowledge about the behavior of the target group and be brave. Be brave. Plus, sometimes on special platforms like Snapchat, simple is better. Sometimes just simple is better than a polished, high-quality campaign video. You saw it in different examples. It's about knowing what affects which reaction from the audience.
Great, thank you. Eric?
Yeah, basically you gave all the tools to play around with, so just play around with, that would be my biggest advice. Just test it, you can test it with a small amount of budget, as we always do. And think Snapchat first, because you want to reach a Snapchat audience, and even if there are other apps with similar formats, let's say it like that, I wouldn't drop the name here, but you could easily think of, oh, I'm creating for this other platform and use the same content for Snapchat. That's not working. And that's one thing that you need to realize. And that is also, customers sense that. It's a question of respect. They sense if you try to take the easy way and cut down a TV ad for a format like this. And that is, and biggest advice is, how can I add value to an experience? Talking about lenses, right? If I want to set a statement, or if I want to position myself in a certain way. Yep. The BMW case is great for that, because they have an urban car as a statement, and you might want to use it as a statement to enrich your profile, to show yourself, express yourself. Okay, this is belonging to me. Great value for the customer, and that's what should be always first, right?
Thanks. Thanks. And Matt, I'm sure lots of people in the audience work with creative agencies and possibly think about how they brief their creative agencies to think about Snapchat. And how would you, what would you kind of give to them as kind of a suggestion of how to work with us? And how
First, download the app, right? I've talked to a lot of people that never even had downloaded the app and registered. Then talk to your kids, get some kids, your family, nieces, and let
get
them
some
explain.
Kids.
No, it's true. Let them explain what they're doing. I really reached out to my nieces, and they were always bored by their stupid uncle. But when I told them we're developing cases for Snapchat, they were listening, showing me how that works. Ah, there's a pinch for the heat map. Really get into the app. That's what I tell everyone. And then again, recruit not only the typical creatives, recruit people, talk to people who are living and who are broadcasting through that mobile lens. And it's a total different speech, and you have to introduce them to your customer to get in touch with them, to get this close contact that you want to reach out.
Fantastic. So, guys, I think we're going to kind of wrap it up there.
Just and follow DJ Khaled, by the way. I don't know whether you
absolutely.
He's got like three guys following him with mobiles, just
by the way,
snapping everything he does. Like,
I was just thinking about you. Sorry that I have to name drop you, but I'm thinking Drake is in the audience. But you're just looking like Drake. But it's amazing. I was happy. Yeah, I mean you.
He's here.
Yeah, he's here. I mean your neighbor.
No, you can learn a lot. Actually,
he's looking like Drake. Come on, man. You got a date today now.
Amazing. Guys, thank you so much. Really great to have you on stage. I hope that if we've left the audience with anything, it is that camera marketing is a medium in itself. We strongly believe at Snapchat, right, we know TV, we know print, we know VOD, we know digital, we know social. We think that the camera is emerging as a new channel, a new medium in itself. It has massively high attention. There's a massively high scale of quality engagement happening in the camera. And hopefully what we've been able to show you today is some great examples of work some great brands are doing to leverage that opportunity. So guys, thank you so much.
Thank you, Will.
For being on the stage.
Thank you, Will. Cheers. Thanks for having us. Leaving?
Yeah, I think so.
Join LeVou and get some kids. That was the sentence I got out of it.
That wasn't the takeaway.
Gentlemen, yeah, gentlemen, thank you very, very much. This was really informative and I think the perfect last session we could have here on the DMEXCO 2018 on our motion stage. And I really have to think about to join LeVou when I see these gentlemen in the ad. So I'm still thinking about it.
Thank you.
So thank you very much. Thanks for your attention, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for a great DMEXCO. Thanks to all speakers and to a great team behind the cameras. Thank you and see you next year. Bye-bye. Ciao.